In this video, we are going to speak about a MOOC course related to flipped classroom. Specific, in this work, we analyze the participants' profile of that course. And for it, two surveys have been carried out, one at the beginning and one at the end. The purpose is to measure the motivation for taking that course, the modules fulfilled, and what characteristics of flipped classroom they have internalized. In the future, this information will be useful to be able to design activities and contents adapted to those different motivational profiles. Now, there is a high demand for MOOC course on flipped classroom, and design a course adapted to the heterogeneity of the participants is a challenge. However, inappropriate design can mean a dropout or a poor development. This MOOC, which is focused on the course shown in the slide, has 6 modules. The last 3 are the modules with the highest degree of innovation, since they are based on the main method. But what is the main method? Let's think for a moment. What can we do if we have ingredients, things to do with them, and tools to do it? Maybe we can make a potato omelette, or maybe educational innovation. This MOOC course focuses on the application base of the main method. It can be seen as a recipe in which the student has to know the functional model, the strategies, and the technological components. As I said before, we have collected information about the course participants. 2 surveys were carried out, one at the beginning of the course and one at the end. Sociodemographic data were collected in both surveys to be able to compare them later. On the other hand, in the initial survey, the reason why the participants decided to take the course were studied. Finally, in the final survey, 2 questions were analyzed: the number of modules fulfilled and their opinion of the proposed flipped classroom model. Next, we are going to analyze the result of the different surveys. 2 of the characteristics analyzed were gender and country. We can observe that the most common profile was Spanish women. The level of studies was also analyzed, observing that the most common were participants with university studies. The last sociodemographic characteristic was the profession, where we see that the field where the course generated more interest was teaching at different levels. Therefore, we can observe that the majority of the participants were women teachers from Spain. And why were all these profiles interested in this course? A survey was carried out where 7 different reasons were asked. They had to answer yes, no, or no, no, that's not answer. In the following graph, we can see the result obtained. In general, we can observe that most of the motivation proposed are relevant to a high percentage of participants. On the other hand, we analyzed how many modules each participant had completed. It's surprising that a high percentage of participants complete the entire course, being more than 90%. Specifically, the module that fewer participants finished was the last one, perhaps because of the theme or its position in the course. Finally, we were interested in knowing their assessment. In the corresponding survey, 8 questions were asked to give their opinion, valuing them from 1 to 4. We can see a horizontal Likert bar chart with the proportion of rate in each category for the 8 items in this survey. To conclude, I would like to emphasize that despite the wide range of profiles and reasons to take the course, most of the participants completed all the modules. In addition, they finished the course with a high degree of satisfaction and agreement with the proposed model. However, as a suggestion for a future work, we believe that it would be productive to adapt the activities or contents to the different profiles, or to create optional modules according to the different interest. I end by thanking the Educational Innovation Service of the University of Zaragoza, which has financed this project, and of course, the organizer of this conference. Thank you so much.